Welcome you, my people. I was just laughing. Messenger of death. Visited messenger of death. Pastor Komoyi of Deeper Life visited Nigeria President Muhammadu Buhari. Messenger of death. Messenger of death. See, I was watching this video of Kumuyi visiting this man. I shake my head. Messenger of death visited messenger of death to congratulate him for the work well done, for the job well done, for the innocent souls, being shed, being slaughtered. You went and you told him that Nigeria is safe under him. I can't believe this. We are praying for you. Praying for who? When God expected you as a man of God, if you are truly a man of God, Mr. Kumi, you are the one that's supposed to invite that man. If you claim that you have God's spirit inside of you are the one that's supposed to terrorize him. Look at the men of old, the true men of God, how they control the authority of this world, how they shake them, how they put fear of God inside of them. But all that people are doing is searching for connection, searching for your pulse. Immediately they say, "Oh, come to us, rock." Immediately you run. Want to be seen with Nigerian president, seen with Buhari, want to be seen with the governors, want to be seen, want to show that you are prominent shrines. Want to show that you are prominent. I am well known. I'm a man of God. This year. You went to congratulate him for the evil that he is doing in Nigeria. You congratulate him for the job, for the blood he is pumping to hell. You congratulate him for being against Christians. You congratulate him. Can't you see that you're not a Christian? That even if you're a bloody Muslim, because even a Muslim hates killing. You can't even look at him and tell him, say that Nigeria is not safe under you. Nigeria is in torment. Nigeria is in pain. But all of you are looking for connection. You are not after the souls of the poor people. You are just flattering. What we are speaking is from here, not from the heart. Look at the way you sit there comfortably with this man. You can't even open your eyes and tell him the truth of what he is doing, that you are not doing the right thing. Even common people in Holland, in London, England, send him packing. Buhari, go home. Buhari, go home. Buhari, go home. Calling him names. Ordinary people that is not having God's spirit, send him packing to Nigeria from London. Shout and scream that this your evil is too visible. But you call yourself a pastor, you call yourself a man of God. You can't even look at this man and tell him, ask him, can you give Nigerians account of the blood of the innocent being shed under your government? Nothing like that. You cannot even tell him that all the evil thing that is manifesting since he entered into power, that God is not happy. You can't even say just a small word like that. You can't even say. I do tire. I become tired so many times when I see how Nigerians are busy following this, worshiping this. People that hated you, people that hated your soul, people that is your enemy, they're threatening you, you give them their money. I have never seen a continent that is against their, I've never seen a country that's against their citizen, that's milking their citizen, that's brainwashing their citizen, that doesn't want their citizen to go forward. I have not seen such, only in Nigeria. You went to congratulate him after everything. You smile. You smile with him. You shake hands with him. You rub. You know, oh, His Excellency, this, that, we are praying for you. praying for him to continue. You have indirect way, you are telling me that you are supporting him to continue. It can never be. Nigerians are not fools. They are no more fools anymore. Their eyes opening every day. They are no more fools like before. I know that next year something will happen. Next year something will happen. All you evil pastors, evil politicians, call yourself pastors. You enemy of righteousness, enemy of God's children. I see the hand of God against all of you. Calamity upon calamity. That evil that you are releasing upon the poor people is upon all of you. God that takes care of the poor and needy, that defends the fathers and the widow, is able to defend the poor Nigerians and to rescue them and save them and deliver them from your people's hand. Because I see totally people are the enemy of Jesus, enemy of the church of Jesus, enemy of the cross. But I trust the one that I'm serving. He's a consuming fire. He's a consuming fire. Look at his wrath is already upon you, all of you. His wrath is already upon all of you. And 2019, I advise you Nigerians to be very, very alert. Vote wisely. Vote for the right person. Vote for AAC. Vote for Mr. Sowore. Vote for a young man with a young vision. These people don't love you. They don't have any love for you in their heart. They are just messengers of death. Look at how you are congratulating Buhari. You went to visit him. It's you that are supposed to call him to visit you and he'll be shaking. But when he said, come to us, Rob, immediately, oh, you move. You are shaking. You know, I went to Asolok. Because Nigerians also like something that say, oh, he's connected to president. If I want to be known by any president, not to Buhari. Not Buhari. Want to be seen. Oh, you want people to know that you are big. If you are a big man of God, you are connected. When you're supposed to control the authority, tell them what to do, instruct them. If you don't do this, the wrath of God will descend on you. Threaten them, put fear inside of them. Nothing like that. Nothing like that. Jump and praise him and tell him Nigeria is saved under you. We are praying for you. I was so tired. I said, this is nothing but. This is nothing but total failure. Nigerian pastors, people have totally failed in every area, totally failed. And my advice to you people is to stop trusting these people. They don't love you. They don't think about you. They are after their own account, their own pulse. They are after their own, you know, their own family. If everything's okay with them, they don't care about you. So but I want to tell you that God cares for you. But you need to be wise. You need wisdom. You need wisdom. Common sense is needed. You need common sense to know some things without anybody telling you. Okay, so I just want to tell you this. Just what I want to tell you is that God is in control of that country called Nigeria. He controls the affairs of man. He controls the authority. Everything is under him, under his control. And he will do the right thing for you, for me, and for you, and for all his children. And he will put things right again. God bless you. Very good. God bless you as you go ahead and study the word of God. You need to know the word of God. You need to know what God says. You need to give your life in totality to Jesus. Pastors will not save you. Going to church will not save you. Evangelism will not save you. What will save your soul is your total commitment to Jesus. Living the life that he wants to, the life in the word of God. Living the life that Jesus wants you to live. Not what your pastor wants you or wants to live or anybody, but the life that Jesus has set for you, the standard he set for me and you. You knowing the word of God makes you to be wiser and makes you to be smarter, makes you to be sharper than the enemy. Go into the Word of God. Read the Word of God. It is very important for your life. It's important for your soul. Feed your soul. Feed your soul with the Word of God. Okay. Amen. Blessed.